Good morning, my dear friends. A hearty welcome to my YouTube channel, Dr. M.H. Annaya Academy. Friends, in today's session, we are going to study how to locate the centroid of an L section or an angle section whose dimensions are as shown in the figure. Friends, here they have not specified the reference from where you have to find out. So, as usual, we will take the left end as the y-axis here and the bottom line passing through the base as the x-axis, and this becomes the origin O. Friends, in this section you have got an L shape which can be split into two rectangles. So splitting can be done either in the vertical direction where you will get one and two rectangles, or it can be done by drawing a horizontal like this, and this is, we can call as number 1, and this is section number 2. So there are basically two rectangles in this L section or the angle section. Friends, you know very well, to find out the x bar and y bar, the centroid, you have the formula given by the formula. X bar is equal to a1 x1 plus a2 x2 divided by a1 plus a2 is the formula used to find out the distance of the centroid from the y-axis. That is the x bar formula. In this formula, let us find out what these terms stand for. Friends, here a1 is the area of this rectangle, so which is nothing but this is 80 and 20. So we can say this has got an area of 80 into 20. That is 1600 millimeter square, because all the dimensions are given in millimeter. Likewise, friends, A2 is the area of this rectangle. So A2 is given by the length into width, 100 into 20. You can say 100 into 20, and this works out to 2000 mm square. Friends, we have this X1 and X2. What is X1 and X2? So, x1 and x2 are the distance of the centroid measured from the y-axis. And we know the procedure that you can get the centroid of the individual figures by joining the diagonals of that rectangle. Suppose if you just join like this, these two diagonals intersect at this point. This is figure number 1, and I will call this as G1. And similarly, for the second rectangle, the same lines, if you join the diagonals, they meet at a common point. I will call this as G2. So G1 and G2 are the centroids of the rectangle 1 and 2. Friends, now we want to have what is x1, x2, etc. x1 is the distance of G1 from the y-axis. That is this quantity, which is 20 by 2. That is 10. This is 10. So I can say x1 is equal to 10 millimeter, and x2 is the distance of G2 from the same y-axis. This is this gap, that is nothing but 50, 100 by 2. So x2 is equal to 50 millimeter. Friends, we have got both the values of x1 and x2, and we should be able to find out what is the value of this x bar. This is 1600 A1. X1 is 10 plus A2 is 2000 multiplied by X2 is 50 divided by A1 plus A2, 1600 plus 2000, that is 3600. So if you simplify this, it works out to 32.32 mm, that's the value of X bar. So x bar is 32.32. Friends, on the same lines, let us see how to find out y bar, that is the distance of the centroid measured from the x axis. So friends, for that we have a similar formula given by the formula, that is y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 divided by a1 plus a2. So already we have calculated what are the values of A1 and A2. So now let's see how to find out Yn and Y2. Friends, what is Y1? Y1 is the distance of G1, the centroid of the first figure, from the x-axis, from the OX. How far is that? Friends, this is 20 and this gap is 40. So 40 plus 20, that is 60. 60 is the value. See, this is 20 plus half of this 80 is 40. 40 plus 20 is 60 mm. On the same line, Y2 works out. What is Y2? Y2 is the distance of G2 from XY or OX. So that this gap, that is nothing but 10, 20 by 2, that is 10. Friends, we know all the values. Let us make the substitution and get the answer for Y bar. That is 1600 is A1, Y1 is 60, plus area of the second figure is 2000 multiplied by Y2 is 10 divided by A1 plus A2. If I add these two, it comes to 3600, and this answer also works out to 32.32 millimeter. So finally, we can write down, friends, the centroid of this L section or the angle section is given by x bar comma y bar is equal to 32.32 mm. That is, for the whole section, the centroid lies at a distance of 32.32 from the y axis and 32.32 from the x axis, because these two arms have got the same dimension. Friends, I thank you very much for watching my YouTube video. Have a nice day.